today we're going to show you some of the basic features of the 4706 and the 5706 series TVs from Philips. A couple basic features of the televisions is that there are going to be three sizes in a 40-inch, a 46, and a 55-inch. They feature SRS True Surround HD and Dolby Digital Plus. True Surround HD creates a surround sound experience from just the two speakers on the television. It's got built-in wireless adapters. They have Philips Media Connect to use the TV as a computer monitor wirelessly. They have both feature Net TV with applications like Netflix, Vudu HD Movies, Vudu Apps, Blockbuster, Twitter, Facebook, Tag Games, and more. USB video and audio playback supports MP3 files, JPEGs, MPEG 1 and 2. The TV that you see in front of you is the 4706 series, which is 120Hz 1080p edge lit LED with a static contrast ratio of 4000 to 1. It has a 5.5 millisecond response time. The 5706 is 120Hz 1080p LCD TV with a static contrast ratio of 5000 to 1 and has a 6 millisecond response time. These are the connectivity ports that we have on the back of the television. We have component inputs in the back. We have one component input right here with its audio. We also have composite video and audio at the bottom with a digital audio output. This is what you would use to hook this into your Philips home theater system to get the sound from the television. It also has four HDMI ports, three in the bottom, an antenna input. You've got the wireless LAN adapter, a USB adapter for our USB port for pictures and video from a USB stick. Audio input that pairs up with the VGA input. You also have another HDMI on the side. And your power cord. Your control buttons are on the right side of the TV. I'm just going to demonstrate for you real quick how to switch sources on the remote. Just press the source button and you'll see that all the sources are listed here. Just select the one that you want to view and it comes up. One other feature is the format button on the remote. If your TV is broadcasting standard definition with the black bars on the side, this will stretch it out or bring it to a different mode. If you just push format, automatic is going to automatically be displayed as the source wants it to. 4x3 is going to be for the standard definition looking series. Widescreen is going to stretch your standard def content out. And unscaled is going to be as it's another way to transmit it as the source wants it to. The info button on the remote will bring up the resolution, picture format, and sound type that is being transmitted from the source. Go through some of the features of it, mainly the internet connected features. How to connect it to a wireless network, the applications it has, and how to use them. The 4706 series TV and the 5706 series TV are 2011 models. They are going to have the exact same menu structure, so we're just going to go through the demos with this one TV. Press the menu button. It gives you these icons up on the screen. The first thing you're going to want to do to connect it to a network is click on Setup. You're going to come down here to Installation and click on Network. And you'll notice this is different than the 2010 TVs is that the Network Setting Assistant is available on the 2011 TVs. So just click that and click Start Now. If you have one of these model TVs and you do not see the network connection, the network setting assistant, then you need to update the firmware on the TV, which can be found at Philips.com. We click on wireless. We have three options. Easy Connect will allow you to go to your router and push the WPS button on it, and it will automatically detect your network name and password. So it's nice to use the Easy Connect if you don't know your network name and password. Scan will scan the area for all the available networks. Manual entry will allow you to enter a network name manually if it's hidden. That's the only time that I would recommend that you use manual entry when using the setting assistant. For this case, since the router's not in this room, we're going to go ahead and hit scan, and it's going to scan all the nearby networks. If you notice here, we've got two networks. One's Philips with a lowercase p, and one's Philips with an uppercase p. You can notice the one on the top is unsecured. There's no lock symbol. The one on the bottom is secured. There's a lock symbol. The signal bars do represent signal strength. So you can see here that they are kind of far away, but we're going to still try and connect to them anyways. We're going to do the bottom one. Just click OK. Again, it's going to try and get you to do the Easy Connect feature. If you have that, you can press that at this time, or if you have a WPS code that your router will give you, you can use that. In this case, we're going to do manual because I know what the password is. It's not manually connecting an IP address at this point. It's manually entering the security key. Alright, once that's entered, you go down and hit OK. Is the setting correct? Yes, it is. This test will tell us whether or not it is connected to the internet. Make sure that you have the latest firmware version on the television before you try and connect it to the network. The connection test has been updated, and it actually will let you know whether or not the TV is getting through to the internet. So just press OK. After you press OK, it brings you out to this screen. You can come down and run a connection test by itself. It's going to run through a similar test that we saw a second ago. It tells you that it succeeds, and then you can press info, and it's going to give you all the numbers, all the IP address, everything like that that's on there. You can see that it's connected to the router, got an IP address. This is the IP address of the actual TV, your subnet mask of the router, the default gateway of the router, the secondary DNS is left blank, there is not picking up one. Philips shows connected to signal strength, security type, and password. Just hit back. Bring it back again and go to setting status. And then the information, you can also come up here and see that as well. You notice at the bottom you have a MAC address that is populated with digits. If that's not populated with digits, then it's possible that the adapter is bad or the USB plug is bad. If that does come up with zero, we recommend pulling the power on the TV for a minute, plug it back in. And if it's still zero, you can attempt to remove the USB adapter from the side of the TV. But it's a little difficult to get to, which I'll show you here in just a second. This is the USB adapter on the TV. It's kind of difficult to get out. You would have to take a pair of pliers and try and get it out. It's a little easier to get out on the 5706 series than it is the 4706 series. The adapters rarely go bad, but if they do, try and unplug the power to the TV for a minute, plug it back in, check the setting status. And if that doesn't work, unplug, plug back in the adapter, and try it again. If after all that you're still not getting a MAC address populated, then the TV would either need repair or service. Now that we've done the wireless test, we're going to go through and show you how to do a reset if you're having trouble connecting to a network. You want to perform a network reset, as well as power cycling your router and the television by pulling the power. So you're going to go down to installation and network. And you're going to go down to network, reset network settings. Start now. The settings have been reset. You can go back and restart the network setting assistant or set it up manually. You can go into setting status after you reset the device's wireless settings to confirm that it has been reset. You notice the MAC address is still listed. Okay, so what we're going to do now is show you how to manually connect a television to a wireless network and when and why you need to connect it manually to the wireless network. So what we're going to do is go to setup, and we're just going to try and set up the wireless network just like you would normally. We want to do this to let us know whether or not we need to set it up manually. You don't need to set it up manually if you don't have to. So we're going to go set it up just like we would normally. We're going to scan for the wireless network. We see our Philips network. We're going to connect manual mode, not because we do manual IP address settings, but manually because we're not using WPS code or Easy Connect for the security key. I know the security key, as should you know your security key to your network, so you can connect the TV easy and other wireless devices. So put that in, hit OK, verify, and it's going to test. You get this error code here. This says that your unit is connected to the home network but not the internet. There is no response from the default gateway. Please confirm the network settings. So what does that mean? The default gateway is your router. What this message is telling us is that your router is not assigning the television an IP address, either because there's an incompatibility with the router and the device, or that the DHCP is turned off in the router, which DHCP is the setting that allows the router to give out IP addresses to all the different internet connected devices in your home. So we're going to hit OK. It did connect to the network, but no IP address. We're going to verify that by going to setting status. Setting status is going to tell us whether or not you have the correct IP address. This IP address, 169.254.138.195, is bogus. That is not given from the router. I know that because most IP addresses start with 192.168.1.0 or .0.1 or .2.1. They can even be 10.0.0.1. But they will never be what you just saw. Let me bring that back up. Because you can also see the default gateway 0, primary DNS, secondary, nothing is filled out other than the wireless network. So we know it's connected to the wireless network, but it's not getting an IP address. Default gateway is 0, just like the error message said. So whenever we get that error, check this network setting status. If it looks like this, then you need to go and assign the IP address manually. And you do that by going to manual network settings. It's already on wireless, we're already on auto, we don't need to go reset it up, it's already connected, we just need to do IP configuration mode. IP setting mode is at auto, we want to push that and change that to manual. And now we can go select and enter our IP address, which you can find the IP address and all these settings from within a computer connected to your wireless network, and directions to that can be found at the link in the description of this video. Okay, so we've entered all this information. And the reason that we chose this 150 is because that the router is only going to broadcast IP addresses from 1 to 255 or within that range. So you don't want to pick one that's above 255. You want to go somewhere in the middle. I like to pick the whole numbers, 150, 120. You want to do it above the number of devices in your home. So if you have 10 computers in your home, you don't want to make this 15, you don't want to make that 1 through 10 because that will overlap. All right, so there's our settings. That's confirmed. Proxy setting you want to keep, do not use. It's only used in intense firewall situations and businesses. So now that we have this hooked up, we're going to go back to the connection test and hit start now and hope that it works. Network connection succeeds. Info. Everything is connected as we entered it into the system. To test, which the test tested the internet, so we know that the internet test passed, that we just did the connection test, so we are confident that any of these features will work. And there you have it. It is connected manually to our router. What I did to the router in order for it to require us to have it manually set up is I turned off the DHCP on the router. So that's just to give you an idea of what can happen to the router, why it causes, what can cause the issues with not assigning IP addresses. We're going to run the connection test now. I've gone and disconnected the internet from the router to show you what the error code looks like. So if you ever run the connection test and you get the error code that's going to pop up in just a second, then your router is not connected to the network, or your router is not connected to the internet. So your unit is connected to a home network, but not the internet. Please check your router settings or contact your ISP or router manufacturer. So right there, it's telling you exactly what's going on. This is only available in the 2011 television and the 2010 and 11 internet-connected Blu-ray home theaters. So you hit info, once again it's giving your IP address and everything. So at this point, if this were an issue in a customer's home or in your home and you get that error message, run through a power cycle, contact your internet provider, make sure your internet's working on the router. Check it with another computer. So that sums up our how-to and information on the 4706 and the 5706 series TVs. If you have any more questions, please visit our website at www.philips.com/support.